Queen Elizabeth II, QE2, one of the largest passenger boats ever built. And here's a model of it. Now, it's actually a converted toy tugboat.
Right.
But there's a problem concerning the QE2. Let's imagine that it leaves from the nearest harbour and sails all the way around the world and back to the same harbour. Which part of the boat, Rob, which part of the boat will travel furthest? The front, the back, or some other part?
Well, that's silly. I mean, the front will leave before the back, but it'll get back there before the back as well. So they go the same distance, but at different times.
Ah, yes, but which part of the boat is highest?
Well, the top of the funnel.
Mm-hmm. Watch the tip of the funnel as the QE2 circumnavigates the Earth. Here it is. Leaves the harbour, goes all the way around, and the tip of the funnel is making a larger circle than the rest of the boat, so it actually goes further.
Ah, I see what you mean. Yes, I suppose it does. Well, on that basis, there's a part of the boat that goes even further.
Really? I wonder what part that is. The QE2 is sailing around the world, and when it does so, the tip of the funnel goes further than most other parts of the boat. But Rob, you say there's another part of the boat that goes even further than the tip of the funnel.
Well, I think there is. Have a look at this. The QE2 is driven by propellers, or screws, and of course they spin. So as they're spinning, they drive it forward. And for every metre that the boat goes, the tip of the propeller must go a lot further. So for my money, it's the tip of the propeller that goes the greatest distance.
Of course. And that's all for this week's show. Goodbye.